الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد. Iman or faith in Islam has different levels and everyone has a different level of faith, and by doing actions that are good actions we increase our faith. By being strong and doing good deeds we increase our faith. And when we're disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that lessens our faith. And those are signs of weak faith. And I wanted to quickly just give a very brief overview of a very important hadith which shows that iman or faith in Islam is comprised of belief in the heart and actions on the limbs. And when we say or make statements it has to do with actions uttered on the tongue. Okay, so iman has different levels, and iman or faith in Islam is comprised of those three components: of sayings, of actions that we do, and the belief in the heart. All those things make up iman or faith in Islam. And in a hadith that shows us that this is the case, that this is the Islamic belief, and is derived from Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we have the hadith of Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiyallahu anhu. قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من راء منكم منكرا فليغيره بيد فإن لم يستطع فبلسانه فإن لم يستطع فبقلبه وذلك أعرف الإيمان. رواه مسلم. Read the hadith for us in English.
Assalamu alaikum. Whosoever from you sees an evil, let him change it with his hand. If he is not able, then with his tongue. And if he is not able, then with his heart. And that is the weakest level of faith.
And that was collected in Muslim. Jazakum Allah khairan. Allah yubarak feek. So this shows us again that iman has different levels. The strongest of those levels, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, has to do with faith in action. So this means doing good actions as well as preventing evil actions. So for example, if you see someone, they're doing something that is disliked by Islam, if you are able to change that harmful thing that they're doing, then you should do so. But of course, that means, according to the scholars of Islam and according to what the Quran and the Sunnah and the understanding of the companion shows us, that we should not try to change that harm if it is going to cause a greater harm by trying to change it. Meaning, for example, if you see someone and they are drinking alcohol, for example, and you decide, you say, hey, you're a Muslim, you're not supposed to drink alcohol, and you begin to try to take the alcohol from them. If you believe that this is going to cause a greater harm, meaning maybe it's going to cause a fight between you and your brother Muslim, or that maybe you're going to be hurt physically by this, or you fear that you may hurt that individual, and maybe the police would get involved, or something that is going to be harmful, then this is something you should not do. And if you are unable to do so, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then it goes to the next level of iman, the next level of faith, meaning that one should speak out against it. So you should advise them, try to advise them with kindness and gentleness, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam advised the Bedouin man, the Arab that came from the outskirts instead of being a city dweller. He came and he urinated in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's masjid. He urinated in the mosque, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't yell and scream at him and curse him or even try to stop him physically. He actually let the man continue until he finished, because it would have caused the man more harm by trying to stop his urinating, and it would have also caused more harm by spreading the urine around the masjid, by making the masjid more filthy. But instead, it was concentrated, the urine was concentrated in a particular part of the masjid. Also, it may have, the people may have hurt, caused this man harm. So this shows us, then the Prophet even let the man continue, because there was more benefit and there was less harm by allowing him to continue. So again, going to the second level of faith in that regard, it is speaking out against an evil action that you see. And again, that shows that iman or faith is also on the tongue. It is also something we utter, okay? Given bearing witness that there is one God and that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the last prophet and messenger is also something we say on our tongue. So this shows us also that that is a part of faith. And then the third level that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in this hadith, he said, and if you are unable to do so, meaning you're unable to change the evil deed with your hands, you're unable to change it with your tongue by speaking out against it, and you are also unable to, so if you're unable to do those two things, then it goes to your heart. Then you should at least hate that evil action that is contained in your heart. You should dislike that. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَذَلِكَ أَدَفُ الْإِيمَانِ, and that is the lowest level of faith. So again, it shows us a very, very important principle, is that Muslims believe that iman has all of those three components. So it's not sufficient for a person who just does bad actions. Maybe they're drinking alcohol, maybe they have a girlfriend, maybe they're doing other things which are prohibited by Islam, and then for them to say, hey, you don't know what's in my heart. That's not sufficient. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made it very clear to us that faith is not only in the heart, but it's also through our actions and on our tongue. It's also something that we pronounce with our tongue. So all of those components are a part of iman. And of course, the iman in the heart is incredibly important, because this result has to do with one's belief. This has to do with one being sincere in their belief and believing in those things and actions that is legislated by Islam. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, to grant us tawfiq and grant us beneficial knowledge. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.